Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we worship you in the beauty of holiness. You are righteous, God. You are a Savior. You are a Redeemer, Lord. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Father. Lord, you are our King. You're the everlasting God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Good morning, good morning, good morning. We're on for our Monday morning prayer. Every Monday, we're praying. Wives who pray. Wives who pray. We're not only praying for our marriages, but we're praying for our world, our city, our governor. We're praying for the crisis that we're in and asking God to bring hope to a hopeless situation. We're praying for our leaders this morning. So we're not only praying for our marriages. It's wives who pray. So we're praying for those in need. We're praying for the homeless. We're praying for those that are dealing with stress and anxiety and worry. And if you just happen to fall into any of those categories, then we're praying for you too. We will pray for marriages this morning. But as I stated on, I believe, Friday, that I also wanted us to focus on praying regarding this coronavirus and just praying for people individually, because so many people are going through. You have some people that are not working right now. You have some people that are working and they're stressed out because they have to be in the building or be, you know, among other people and still have to face the public. We have those that have children at their home and they don't have any care for their children. And they're having to now homeschool. You have some people that, you know, although they love their children, they're just not built for that. And I understand it. And that can be a hard task. So we're praying for several things this morning. So come on in. Come on in. Good morning, Felicia. Good morning, Lashandra. Good morning, Kim. Good morning, Savania. Good morning. Good morning. So we are wives who pray. Going before the throne of God. Praying for the world at large. And that's one of our responsibilities as Christians, Christ followers, believers, to be intercessors, to intercede on behalf of others, to pray against the things that are going on in the world. You know, it's not just a praying for us, and that, you know, it's to pray for things that are going on in the world. We get up in early morning to pray. And I have designated days that I pray for myself. However, on the other days, I really try to pray for other people and take myself out of the equation and knowing that it's bigger than me. What's going on in the world is bigger than me. What's going on around me is bigger than me. That there are people that are around me that I should be praying for, that I should be lifting up. And some will never, ever know how to pray for themselves. So as it relates to this virus that's going on, just know that this is not the work of God. You know, God does permit things to happen, just like in the story of Job, when Satan came and he was trying to find somebody to harass, more or less. And God said, did you consider my servant Job? My servant is righteous. My servant is faithful. My servant will not turn his back on me. Try him, but don't touch him. Don't touch his life. You know, there are times where God would say, try her, but don't touch her life. Yeah, go ahead and do what you do, but you have limits. You have bound. There are boundaries that you must abide in. And there are lines that you cannot cross. So know that this is not something that God brought on the nation to get our attention or to, what have I heard? Get our attention or to, I've just heard so many things. Now, Will you use the opportunity? Absolutely. And for some of us, we needed to slow down. We needed to just really reflect. I saw a post yesterday, and it was a great post. I can't remember exactly what it said, but it said, you know, we worshiped other gods. God took away the TV. God took away everything that we love, more or less. And there are times we see, you know, with Israel and all the other things that he did throughout scriptures when individuals were disobedient. However, for this coronavirus, this is the works of the devil. This is the works of the devil. And this is an oppression of the devil. When we go to Acts 10 and 38, it says how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and oppressing all those that were of the devil, healing all those that were oppressed of the devil. So what we're asking God to do this morning is to bring healing to the land. Second Chronicles 7 and 14 says, if my people who are called by my name will pray and humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sins and I will heal their land. So we're asking God to heal our land this morning. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against him. We're asking God to lift up a standard against this virus on today. We're just asking him to lift up a standard against the war that we're in right now. And we're asking the standard of the blood to be raised by the power of God's Spirit against this viral enemy and against all demonic attacks, all demonic spirits that's moving throughout the earth. We understand that we have the armor of God on. We have on a helmet of salvation. We have on the breastplate of righteousness. We have on the belt of truth. We have the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. We have the shield of faith, and we're praying always. And our feet are shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. We have to make sure that every day we have on our armor. And yes, we can take full advantage of this time of being in isolation, aka quarantine. We can take advantage of this time of being slowed down, take advantage of this time of not being as busy and having too much stuff to go on. We can definitely take advantage of this time, but know that God is a consuming fire. And we want God to release his fire in the land and to move quickly in the earth and destroy this plague that is among us right now. So Father in heaven, Lord, we thank you for this day, God. We thank you for your love toward us, Lord. We thank you for your faithfulness, oh God. We thank you for your consistency, oh God. We thank you that you are God, and beside you there is none other. Hallelujah. Forgive us, God, for allowing other things to be our God. Forgive us for turning to other things to comfort us, other things as a form of protection, like our finances and our jobs. Forgive us, oh God, for making those things priority over you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Forgive us, Father, for being out of line and out of alignment with your word concerning our lives, even concerning our marriages, so Lord God. Lord, the things that we've taken for granted in the past, may we no longer take them for granted. May we learn to be faithful to our husbands and not faithful from sexual morality, although yes, that too. We're faithful and consistent in our love toward him. Faithful and consistent toward our actions and our behavior toward him, and the same as he. Lord, we're very clear on what your word says of how a marriage should be. And maybe before this world crisis, there was crisis in our home. And for some, there may still be crisis, oh Lord God. But just like this is a plague in the earth, and just like this is works of Satan in the earth, this works of Satan even in our marriage, Some things are our responsibility. Some things we brought on ourselves, oh God. And we ask you now, dear Father, to expose those areas of our life, to show us the areas where we can improve and we can be better, not just for the sake of improving and being better, but for the sake of our own lives, for the sake of our relationship with you, for our sake of our relationship with our spouses, oh Father. Lord, in the same way our land needs healing, our marriages need healing. And we're asking for your healing, God. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against every enemy in our life, every enemy in the earth. God, we need your standard on this morning. Show us us. Create in us a clean heart and renew in us a right spirit. Your spirit is the right spirit. Cast us not away from your presence, O Lord God. We come to you, Lord God, before the sun comes out this morning, giving you our first fruits, understanding how important it is to cry out and to spare not. So God, we pray for marriages that are just living day to day and trying to figure it out. I pray that couples are willing to put in the work that's required to establish a healthy home, a sustainable marriage, a godly marriage. Lord, that we turn to scriptures, not to people, not to things, not to what the world is doing, but we turn to your word to get instructions on how we should show up in that marriage every single day. Lord, everything that's unresolved, may it be resolved in the name of Jesus. May we stop accusing and blaming one another and learn how to stick together, Lord, and pray together, worship together. May we learn the art of forgiveness and be okay with forgiving because it's your principle. We are to forgive those who trespass against us. We stand in a place of forgiveness today, Lord God. Let us not remember their transgressions. Let us stop recalling what happened. Let us stop going in with the negative mindset. Lord God, all of the regrettable incidents that we may have encountered and experienced in our marriages, Lord God, allow us to let it go. Learn to get over those humps and those hurdles so they will no longer be stagnant in our marriage and hold us back. God, we have your heart. We have your mind. Oh, Lord, create in us a clean heart. Let this mind be in us, which was also in you. We adopt your mind, Abba Father, so that we think your thoughts, which is your word. And those things are demonstrated in our marriages every single day. Show us, God. Let us put the mirror of the word of God in front of our faces and see our reflection. In the name of Jesus, I pray love abounds, trust abounds, respect abounds. Help us to get over the betrayal and the rejection that we've experienced for so very long, and how those things have impeded in our marriages and has caused great friction. Show us this morning. Now, Heavenly Father, we're praying against this crisis that we're in. Lord God, this is an opportunity for us, an opportunity to get closer to you, an opportunity to get closest to our spouses, an opportunity for our purpose to be actualized or to discovered. And although this may be the worst time of our life right now in this 21st century, God, we still give you praise. For we know that all things work together for your good. Not that they're good, But we know all things work together for your good. And we will give thanks in all things. Although we don't like it, we don't agree with it, we will give thanks. God, we ask now that you have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon the land. If your people who are called by your name will humble themselves and pray and seek your face. Lord, we just need to turn from the ways of the world. Turn toward the things of God. Then you will hear from heaven. You will forgive our sins. You will heal our land. In the same way, God, you were there for the children of Israel. We understand it was because of their disobedience, their stubbornness, the wanting to do things their way that kept them in bondage. So God, I pray that we have a different mindset on today. We have a different mindset in the midst of this crisis, that we don't want things to go our way, but we want them to go your way. So God, may we be obedient and listen to your voice during this time, in the season of crisis, so that we can be freed from the place of bondage, free from this wilderness, and we will enjoy the land of milk and honey. So dear Father, I pray for those that are experiencing anxiety and fear and worry today. Your word says to cast all of our cares and worry on you, for you care for us. Lord, that you will be with us always, even until the end of this world. Lord, that there is no good thing that you will withhold from us. Hallelujah. Your word says in Luke 12:22, it says, do not worry what we shall eat about our body or what we shall wear. Life is more than food, for the body more than clothes. Consider the ravens, they do not sow or reap. They have no storeroom or barn, yet God feeds them. And how much more valuable are we than birds? Who of you by worrying can add a single hour to your life? Since you cannot do this very thing, why do you worry? So we will not worry, even in the midst of chaos, even in the midst of crisis. For Psalms 27:1 reminds us that the Lord is our light and our salvation. Whom shall we fear? The Lord is the stronghold of our life. Of whom shall we be afraid of? Deuteronomy 31:6 tells us to be strong and courageous, to not be afraid or terrified because of them. Them, the crisis. Them, the virus. Them, the world tragedy. For the Lord, our God, will be with us. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Lord, you will not let the righteous fall, and we are the righteous. Isaiah 41:13-14 says, I am the Lord, your God, who takes hold of your right hand, says the Lord. Do not fear, daughter. Do not fear, son. I will help you. Do not be afraid for myself, for I myself will help you, declares the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. For Psalms 46 says, God is our refuge and our strength and ever-present help in the time of trouble. God, we're in a time of trouble right now, and we need your help. Psalms 118:6-7 said, the Lord is with us. Do not be afraid. What can man do? The Lord is with you. He is your helper, Felicia. He is your helper, Lashanja. He is your helper, Bonnie. He is your helper, Tina. He is your helper, Tiffany. He is your helper, Katrina. He is your helper, Michelle. The Lord God is with you. Fear of man will prove to be a snare, but whoever trusts in God is saved. Proverbs 29:25. The fear of man is a trap. It will trap you. It will keep you in bondage. So those that are concerned and worry and have fear regarding their finances, regarding their jobs, regarding the outcome of all of this, Know that the fear of man is a trap. But whoever trusts in God is safe. You are safe. You know, on social media, they have those mark yourself as safe. You can mark yourself as safe on this morning. Because the God has kept you safe. Mark 4, 39 through 40, God got up. Jesus got up. He rebuked the winds and said to the waves, quiet, be still. God is saying to every wave, every wind in your life today, every wind in the earth today, to be quiet, to be still. Then the wind died down and it was completely calm. I speak complete calmness over your life today. I speak complete calmness in the earth today. I speak peace by the authority that God has given me through his spirit in the earth today. He said to his disciples, which are you and I? Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith? Has God not proven himself to you over and over and over and over again? Has he not brought you out of things over and over and over again? Did he not bring you out of Hurricane Hugo and Hurricane Katrina, all the world disasters and crises? Did he not bring you through 9-1-1, the personal crises and tragedies in your life? Did he not bring you through those? Why are you afraid? Psalms 34:7, the angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear him, and he delivers us. And I'm going to leave off this portion of the prayer and pray Psalms 91 so that we remember that God is our refuge. Hallelujah. For he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. We will say of the Lord, he is our refuge and our fortress, our God. In him will we trust. Surely he shall deliver us from the snare, the trap of the fowler, and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover us with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be our shield and our buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror that by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at our side, and 10,000 at our right hand, but it shall not come nigh us. Only with thine eyes shall I see and behold the reward. See, I behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou hast made the Lord, which is our refuge, even the Most High, our habitation. There shall no evil befall us, neither shall any plague come nigh our dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over us to keep us in all our ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest we dash our foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under our feet. Because he hath set his love upon me. Because we've set our love upon him, therefore he will deliver us. He will set us on high because we know his name. Somebody say, I know his name. He is Father. Who is he to you? He is Protector. Who is he to you? He is Provider. Who is he to you? He is Comforter. Who is he to you? He is Peace. He shall call upon me, I will answer you. God says that he will be with us in trouble. He will deliver us and honor us with long life. Will he satisfy us and show us his salvation? So we curse the plague that's upon our land today, and may it be consumed by God's fire. May it be cut off at the root of the source where which it originated from. May its roots be destroyed by fire. Hallelujah. Cut off the hands and the head of the enemy today, God, that it works no more evil in the land. Hallelujah. And God, we pray for our leaders. We pray for our governors on this morning. In the name of Jesus, We pray for our president, God. We pray for wisdom. On this morning, this is not the time for showboating. This is not the time to prove anything to anyone. This is not the time to blame. This is not the time to point the finger, but this is a time for unity. Heavenly Father, we pray for our nation on this morning. Give President Trump, give the House, give Congress, our governors, our mayors, our senators, our representatives, Lord God, all of those in state, local government, the judiciary system, Lord God, the Supreme Court justice, give them wisdom beyond their understanding and the courage to choose the right path, no matter how narrow the gate. We pray for all in authority over us that you would give them the grace and strength to stand against the temptation to use the power, to use power as a weapon, but rather to carry it reverently as one with a child. We pray for the spiritual leaders of our country that they would hear your voice and know your heart. We pray that they would lead with their knees and by the simple grace bring each one of us to our knees before your throne. Have mercy on our nation, dear Father. And Lord, we pray for our leaders, our pastors, our bishops, our apostles. This is a trying time for them of whether to have service or not, whether to get online or not. Some are not equipped to do virtual church. And there's a burden on their heart to still speak to their people and to get the word out. God, I pray we understand that operating in wisdom does not mean that we're fearful. I've seen so many Facebook posts, and I might do a Facebook Live after this. We're still praying, God. Of people bashing people, of how they're choosing to worship and choosing to pray and choosing what God and what religion they're serving. It's so annoying to me that we are so focused on that. So God, I pray for those leaders that have a burden to be able to reach their people, that they find some way that they get on a conference call or use some form of technology. Meeting in place is too risky. I pray that they take other measures and that we understand that we have to obey the laws of the land. So if the governor, if the president is telling us to not be in places of 10 or more, that we use wisdom, that we're just not so careless and reckless as a people. And even as the body of Christ, to say things, oh, God got me and the blood of Jesus covered me, and all that is true. However, when we disobey, there are consequences for that. So we have to operate in obedience. Amen. I pray the spirit of counsel and might and the spirit of knowledge shall rest upon our pastors and our leadership, and particularly my leadership. Call it your leadership. Apostle Alan H. Simmons, First Lady Jan Simmons, Pastor Christian Simmons, I pray that as your spirit rests upon them, that you make them of quick understanding, because the Lord, you have anointed and qualified them to preach the gospel to the meek, the poor, the wealthy, and the afflicted. You have sent them to bind up and heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the physical and spiritual captives, and the opening of the prison and the eyes to those who are bound. Father, our leaders shall be called priests of the Lord. People will speak of them as ministers of God. They will eat the wealth of the nations. I pray and believe that no weapon formed against my apostle, my first lady, my senior pastor shall prosper, and that any tongue that rises against them in judgment shall be shown to be in the wrong. I pray that you will prosper them abundantly, physically, spiritually, and financially. Lord, I thank you that they hold fast and follow the pattern of wholesome and sound teaching in all faith and love, which is of you, Christ Jesus, that they guard and keep with the greatest love the precious and adopted truth, which is the word of God, and trust to them, Lord God, by the Holy Spirit who abides in each and every one of us. Lord, I pray and believe that each and every day freedom of utterance is given to our leaders, that they will open their mouths boldly and courageously as they should to get the gospel to the people. So I thank you for witty inventions and creative ideas of how they will be able to do that if Facebook Live is not a possibility. I thank you, Lord, for the added strength which comes superhumanly that you have given each and every one of our leaders according to Ephesians 6, 19, and 20. Father, as a prayer warrior, as an intercessor on this morning, we will stand with our leaders and undergird them in prayer, God. We will not speak negativity or speak bad things over their lives. We will not judge them for things that they decide to do or don't decide to do. We will leave that up to you, Lord God. We will only edify and build them up. We will not allow ourselves to stand in a place of judgment. But we will continue to intercede and speak the blessings of the Lord over their life, over their ministry, over their marriages, over their finances, over their businesses. God, we speak. And if we feel like our leaders are in the wrong in any way, God, let us pray about it. Let us pray about it and ask you to deal with your servant. But God, we thank you. We praise you. It's in your son Jesus' name. Hallelujah. It's in your son Jesus' name. I want to play a little of this song. Hallelujah. Because I want to be reminded. That's our prayer. I want us all to be reminded on this morning. I know we went a little long this morning, but I pray that this has been a blessing to you this morning. And I pray that you are reminded that we will never be defeated. It's the greatest power. We shall never, good morning, Javonna, never be defeated. Good morning, Crystal. Because God is the greatest power. I shall never be defeated. Hallelujah. And because God, just sit with me for a moment and worship. Is the greatest power. I shall never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, I shall never be defeated. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Let this resonate with your soul this morning.
I shall be. I shall go in victory. No weapon formed against us will ever overtake me. I shall rise.
Hallelujah.
I shall live, I shall grow in victory. No weapon formed against me will ever overtake me. And because
I'm gonna share the lyrics so you guys can sing along.
Greatest power. I shall never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power,
never be defeated.
We shall never be defeated. Hallelujah.
A couple more minutes, you guys. If you can, if you have to leave, I understand. Thank you, replay viewers. I appreciate you for staying on this long.
I shall rise. I shall be. I shall go. In victory. No weapon formed against me will ever overtake me. And because God is the greatest power, I shall shall never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, I shall never be defeated.
Yes, yes. The devil is a liar. Come on, y'all. God is exalted. Never be defeated. Never be defeated. The devil is a liar. God is exalted. Never be defeated. Never be defeated. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Never be defeated. Never be defeated, even in your marriage. Hallelujah. He keeps on lying, y'all. He's a liar. Hey. Y'all gotta believe it. He's a liar. Everything he says is a lie. Everything. He'll try to mix the truth in, but he's a liar. Know the voice of God so you can know when the lie is present. You gotta know the voice of God. Know the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil is a liar. Hey. Hey.
the devil is a liar. God is exalted. I'll never be defeated. You'll never be defeated. The devil is a liar. God is exalted. I'll never be defeated. You'll never be defeated.
Even when you feel defeated, even when you feel defeated, we can't go by our feelings and our emotions. Your belief and your faith and your trust in God has to trump what you feel. Your belief, your trust, and your faith in God has to trump. It must trump. It must overpower. It must override what you feel, because your feelings will tell you things that are not true. Your feelings will make you believe things that are not true. Your feelings will keep you stuck when you need to be free. Your feelings will keep you bound when you should be free. Your feelings will keep you sick when you should be healed. Your feelings will keep you broke when you should be rich. My God, hallelujah. Your feelings will tell you this marriage is not working out. I don't know. Stop trying. It's not going to work. Your feelings want you to recall and remember all of the bad things, all of the negative things, and try to put this puzzle together to prove your point that it's not working. But the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. Hey, y'all better know it. He wants you to build a case. Want you to build this case against your own. Oh, glory to God. I got to get off here. He wants you to build a case against your husband. That's what he wants you to do. He wants you to build a case to prove your point. He don't want you to come together. He don't want you to be on one accord. He don't want you to close the gap of disunity. I'm telling you, know the voice of the Lord. Know when the hand of God is at work, and know when the hand of the enemy is at work. The devil is a liar in the name of Jesus. Is a liar. He's a liar. Never be defeated. All right, y'all. Listen, when I play that song, I go in, honey. I just start thinking about the harassment and the torment of the enemy and everything that he's attempted to do in my life, in my marriage, and he's attempting to do even in the earth. And I just have to remember that we will never be defeated. Even though it looks like defeat, even though it looks like the last round in the ring, and it looks like our opponent is defeating us. Even when it looks like that, we can't go by what we see in our natural eyes, even in our marriages. We can't allow what we see to cause us to become discouraged, because God, he's the greatest power. Because God is the greatest power.
Is the greatest power. You shall never, never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never.
Lay your hands on your chest. Lay your hands on your mind. Your mind will not be defeated. Come on. Even when you get discouraged, tired, weary, confused, hallelujah. Even when it looks like hope is lost. Hallelujah.
Be defeated.
Bless you all on this morning. I thank you all for just staying with me and just going through that worship experience. Hallelujah. I pray you all have an amazing week. I'll see you all on Friday. We're finishing up our submission series. Submission isn't a dirty word. Submission isn't a dirty word. I pray that you guys replay this prayer as much as you need, as much as you desire to pray it, play it over and over and over again, even in the midst of what we're going through. And I'll probably do a watch party in here later today with this very same prayer, so others can get an opportunity to watch it. And I may even download it and post it in other forums, because I really want people to resonate with this one this morning. So you all have a beautiful and a blessed day. I love you all with the love of Jesus, and I'll talk to you soon.